Okay, so we've talked about turtles, which are the basic mobile agents and probably the agents that you'll use the most often within your NetLogo models. But there are two other types of agents that exist within the NetLogo space. One is the patches. Patches are the immobile background objects that exist behind every single space of the world. And they may not be obvious because they're all black, but the world you're seeing here is actually composed of many different patches. And in fact, we can address them much like we address the turtles by saying ask patches to do something, right? And the patches, much like the turtles, for instance, have a color. And so we can set their P color, which is their patch color. And we'll explain in a second why that's different than color for the turtles. But we could set their P color to be a particular value. So one thing we could do, for instance, is set their P color to be dependent upon their X coordinate and their Y coordinate. And for the patches, that's PX core and PY core. So in this case, I'm asking the patches to set their P color to be PX core times PY core. And when I hit enter, you'll now see that the patches are there fairly obviously, right? And that there's a number of different ones there in the space. And in fact, if you remember back to the first subunit of this unit, we discussed how you can modify the settings of the world in order to make more or less patches within the world, right? So we can use patches in much the same way we use agents. They have full properties. We can look at them. We can manipulate those properties. In fact, we can inspect one of the patches. We can do an inspection on it, and then we can see what properties it has. This is PX core, PY core, a P color, a P label, and a P label color, right? What's interesting about patches in other respects and their interaction with turtles is that turtles have direct access to all the different patch variables, right? So for instance, we can create a bunch of turtles now, right? Create 100 turtles, and we can ask those turtles to go to a random y x coordinate and y coordinate. So now they're scattered across the screen. And now we can have the turtles set the patch variables. So we can ask the turtles set the patch color to my color, right? And the reason why this works is because every turtle can only ever be on one patch at a time. So it only has access to one set of patches. And this is why the color variable for the turtle is named something different than the patch color variable for the patch, right? By the way, in addition to random X core and random Y core, there is also random PX core and random PY core, which will give you random patch coordinates. And those are at the center of the patches. And we can also use patches in a different way. So let's set all the patches back to black just so we could set them, right? So we can make them, ask patches. There we go, set P color black. I made a small typo. We could, for instance, use turtles to find their local patches. So we can ask the turtles set XY, which means face a particular XY coordinate. And we're gonna have them face the coordinate of their current patches, right? And so this is aiming them at the center of the patch they happen to be standing on. So in this way, we can have turtles and patches. They can interact. They can work together in interesting ways, and you can use them to kind of manipulate the actions of your turtles. Now, in addition to patches, there's one last command agent type that exists. And we won't spend a lot of time talking about this now, but I want you to know about it, which is the link agent type. And the link agent type allows us to move beyond having a physical attribute of the turtles to having a network-based attribute. So we can ask the turtles to create links, create a link with one of the other turtles. And what you now see is that they've all created links. Now that command was a little complex, so let me dissect it real quick. So we asked each turtle to create a link with, a singular link with, one of, and one of basically takes a random element of a set, other turtles. And other turtles takes the set of all turtles and removes me, the turtle that's currently calling it, and just looks at the other turtles. So it's saying create a link with one of the other turtles. Nice thing about NetLogo is often the English interpretation of the phrase is actually the way the model will actually run, right? Now here I'm creating an undirected link, but you could create directed link. That command is create link to one of other turtles or create link from one of other turtles. And I can create multiple links at the same time. So I can create links with rather than link with one of the other turtles, right? One last little comment is links are full-fledged agents just like turtles and patches. So I can actually look at the properties of those links. And one of the properties is the ends. And so we can see what turtles they connect, the color, the label, et cetera, et cetera. So those are the three basic agents in NetLogo, turtles being the most basic and most common type you're going to work with. But their patches and links are very much important and have many of the same properties and abilities that a turtle does.